Hello guys and welcome to our YouTube channel Scratch Learners. In this video, we are going to discuss about the instruction set of 8085 microprocessor. So the first one is, what is an instruction? So an instruction is a command given to microprocessor or the computer to perform a specific operation on given data. This is very simple and formal definition of an instruction. It is a command given to microprocessor to perform a operation on some data. And what is an instruction set? The entire group of instructions is called the instruction set, which determines what functions the microprocessor can perform. So whatever functions the microprocessor is going to perform is dependent on the instruction set. So 8085 microprocessor has many types of instruction. There are many numbers of instruction, and depending on some functionalities or some key points, they are being combined into different types of instruction set. The 8085 instructions can be classified into the following five functional categories. The first one is the data transfer instruction, then the arithmetic instruction, the third one is logical instructions, then the branching instruction, and the last one is IO and machine control instruction. Now we will discuss about all these five categories in details. The first category of instruction set is the data transfer instructions. As the name suggests, it means that some data is going to be transferred from one place to another place, right? So these instructions transfer or copy a data from one register to another register, or it can also transfer or copy data from one memory to another register and vice versa. That means whenever some data transfer is taking place between registers and memory, then it is a data transfer instruction. So here the data transfer is taking between the source and the destination, right? And this is taking place without modifying the content of the source. So whenever some data is being copied into destination, the source content is not modified or changed. It will remain same as it is. Now, as the data transfer can take place between memory and registers in many ways, so let's discuss about all those one by one. So the first one is MVI R, 8-bit data. Here MVI means move immediate, and R is a register, and this is an 8-bit data. So as we know, there are many registers in 8085. These are the registers, right? And here the HL register is called the memory register. Okay, so this is always memory M. So here R means either B, C, D or E register. This is the syntax. If we take an example like MVI B, 64 hex. Okay, this is the data 64 hex which is going to transfer into the register B. Okay, so MVI B, 64 hex will load the 8-bit data 64 hex into the register B. Then the next one is move R1, R2. So here R1 and R2 are both the registers. That means here we are going to copy data from source register, that is R2, to the destination register, that is R1. So here first we are going to write the destination register where we want to copy the data, and the second register will be our source register. So if we take an example like move B, A, that means some data is going to be transferred from the source register A to the destination register B, right? And here A is accumulator. Accumulator is also a register. Okay, so registers can be A, B, C, D and E, and HL is the memory. So for this, if we take an example like the accumulator register contains some data like 4F hex, okay, and B contains some random data, let's say 30 hex. Okay, these numbers are in hexadecimal, that's why we are having from the digit 0 to 9 and from A to F. So here on executing move B, A, the content of accumulator will be copied into B. That means now the register B will contain the value 4F hex, and the content of accumulator will not be changed. It will remain same. Now the next one is move R, M. So here M is memory. That means the address pointed by the HL register pair, and R is any register. So here, if we take that, this is memory, okay? These are different memory locations, okay? And let's say our HL pair is pointing to this location. And we know that addresses are always of 16 bits, right? So let's take its address as 1200 hex. Then the next one will be 1201 hex, 1202 hex, and so on, right? So this address is 1202 hex. And let's say in this memory, there is a data, let be 4F hex. So on executing move R, M, the data which is present in the memory specified by HL pair will be copied into the register R. So let's say for an example, R is any register, let's say B, and here it is M. So if our M register, that is the content of memory, is 4F hex, then it will transfer the data 4F hex into the register B. Now the next instruction is move M, R. This is the reverse of move R, M. That means this instruction will copy the data byte from the register into the memory specified by the address in the HL pair. So let's say at any point HL is pointing to this location. So let's take an example like move M, C. So if the C register contains some data like 12 hex, okay, then this data will be stored in the memory location pointed by the HL pair. So if HL pair is pointing here, then the value 12 hex will be stored at this location. Now the next instruction is LXI R, 16 bit address or data. So this LXI instruction will load a 16 bit data into a register pair. So if we consider an example like LXI D, let's consider an address 1250 hex. So as we know, a register contains 8 bit address. But here, if we want to store the 16 bit address, then we need to use the register in pairs. So as we know, B is paired up with C, D is paired with E, and H is paired with L. That's why it is memory. So here, as pairing is taking place between D and E, so this LXI instruction will load a 16-bit data into a register pair. As both the registers D and E have a maximum capability of holding 8-bit data, so the last two lower significant bit will be stored in the register E. Okay, and the highest significant 2 bits will be stored in the register D. Okay, so this is the purpose of LXI instruction. Now in the same way, we have LDA instruction. This LDA instruction is used to store the 16-bit data into accumulator. Okay, this is load into accumulator. So if we take LDA 1250 hex, then this data is going to be stored into the accumulator. So in memory, if there are many slots, okay, and now HL is pointing to this location and this is 1250 hex. So whatever data, let's say if it contains 03 hex, so this data 03 hex, which is stored in the address 1250 hex, will be loaded into accumulator. So now accumulator will be containing 03 hex. And the reverse of LDA is STA, 16 bit. So what it will do? It will store the content of accumulator into a memory which is pointed by that 16 bit address. So if you take STA C000 hex, so whatever data is being stored into accumulator will now be stored in this address C000 hex. So these are some simple data transfer instructions. There are also many different types of data transfer instructions like LDAX, STAX, out and in. Here LDAX is used to store or copy a 16-bit data into accumulator from some memory. This is used to load 8-bit data. This is used to load 16-bit data. Similarly, STAX is for storing a 16-bit data into memory. Then out instruction is used to send data byte from accumulator to an output device. And N instruction is used to accept data byte from some input device and place it into accumulator. Now the second one is the arithmetic instructions. So these instructions perform arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, increment and decrement. These are pretty simple. Now let's take example of all these types of instructions. So coming to the category of addition, we have some instructions like add R. Here R is in register, right? So we can take it as add B. There need to be at least two operands for addition subtraction, right? So whenever we are having a single operand, this is taken as the second operand, and the first operand is always accumulator, that means the register A. This is implicitly taken, so there is no need to mention these into these statements. So this instruction add B will add the content of register A with the content of register B, and it will store the result in register A only. So let's say if the accumulator contains some data 0 to hex and the register B contains a data 51 hex. So these two will be added, so we will get 53 hex, and it will be stored into accumulator. Then the second one we have is add M. That means the content of accumulator will be added with the content of memory. So in some memory location, if this is memory, okay, and the content is 34 hex, and let's say the accumulator contains some data 30 hex, okay, so this contents of memory and accumulator will be added. So here we will get 64 hex, and it will be stored in the accumulator. In the same way, we have third instruction for addition, and this is ADI. So ADI 8-bit data. So it means that we will directly add the content of accumulator with the 8-bit data that is given here. For example, ADI 30 hex. Okay, and our accumulator, let's say it contains 15 hex. So on executing ADI hex, these two data will be added. So here we will get 45 hex, and it will be stored back into accumulator. This was for addition. Now in the same way, for subtraction, we have some instructions like SUBR. Let's say SUBB. So as I have already said, the accumulator is always the first operand, and the whatever register is being mentioned here is the second operand. So sub B will subtract the content of register B from the register A. So if we take an example like the accumulator contains the data 55 hex and the register B contains the data 05 hex. So on subtracting, we will get 50 hex. So this will be the content of accumulator after executing sub B. Now in the same way, we have sub M. So this will subtract the content of memory from the accumulator, and the address of memory is in HL pair, right? So you can perform the subtraction in the same way. Now for immediate subtraction, we have SUI instruction. So if we take SUI and 8-bit data, let's say it is 7F hex. So now this content will be subtracted from the content of accumulator. Now for increment, we have instructions like INR. Now if we have instruction like INRC, that means this will increment the content of register C. Let's say if the C register contains some data like 10 hex. Okay, so on incrementing, the updated content will be 11 hex. In the same way, we have INRM. What it will do? It will increment the content of memory. Here, let the memory register is containing some data, some 8-bit data. Let it be 1E hex. Okay, this is the data pointed by the memory. So on execution of increment M, this data will be incremented by 1. That means it will be plus 1. So we will get 1F hex. So this will be the updated content of memory. In the same way, we have instruction for decrement, that is DCR. So if the register C is containing the value 11 hex, okay, so on decrementing the value, we will get 10 hex. Similarly, if we perform DCRM, so this data will be decremented by 1 and we will get 1 E hex again. And we also have instructions like INX and DCX. If we take an example like INXH, so this will increment the content of register pair. We know H is paired with L, that is, this is memory, right? So at any instance, if memory is pointing to this location, okay, let it be 1400 hex, then on execution of INXH, the memory will now be pointing to this address, that means 1401 hex. So INXH is used to increment the content of register pair. Similarly, DCX is used to decrement the content of register pair. So now, if the memory is pointing to this location, then on execution of DCXH, it will again point to this location, that is 1400 hex. So this was about the arithmetic instructions in 8085 instruction set. We will discuss about the logical branching and IO and machine control instructions in the next video. So see you in the next video. Thank you.